Hey guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we're gonna check out the ROCKWOOD Signature Ultralight Series. This is a fifth wheel. This is called the 8290BS. A little bit about ROCKWOOD. ROCKWOOD is the premier level. This is their signature series. So this is their fanciest version of ROCKWOOD. ROCKWOOD is the number one selling fiberglass travel trailer out there. They also happen to make fifth wheels, pop-ups, hybrids. They make the whole gamut. This is specifically out of their signature plant, which is they have the highest ratings out of all the Forest River plants, which that's pretty amazing. So what they do is they have a pre-delivery inspection department that randomly takes campers from each plant out of hundreds of plants that Forest River has, and they send it to this facility where they have a rain booth. They have technicians that have lots of years underneath their belt, and they pick apart these campers as much as possible. And ROCKWOOD, the signature ROCKWOOD plant, is the one that has scored the highest for the last 5 years running. Like I mentioned, this is the ultralight series. This weighs dry weight of 9688. That's just as is. That's before you put any of your camping gear, water, all that kind of sort of thing on board. The GVWR is 11,712 pounds. This has a fresh water capacity of 43 gallons, a black water capacity or sewer tank capacity of 45 gallons, and it actually has two tanks. It has a gray tank and a galley tank, giving you a total of 90 gallons of gray water. Starting with the front cap, you'll notice this has nice white LED lights. That's nice instead of the blue. We found out that the blue ones, policemen do not like those to be on while you're traveling down the road, so the white is a really good choice. This also, if you have a short bed truck or a standard bed, which is about 6, 6.5, 5.5 foot, as opposed to the 8 foot, you need some way to make sure that the cab of your truck isn't going to go into the corners. So these are peeled back a little bit, as well as this has the Reese Revolution Kingpin. What this does is, instead of it pivoting right here where the hitch would connect into, it can pivot back here 22 inches. The benefit is it keeps the entire camper further away from the cab of your truck so you don't accidentally hit the corners, because those slider hitches are great, except for they are only as good as you remembering to slide it back. I've had several people, unfortunately, come in and have to repair the corners of the campers and the broken out window in their cab of their truck because they had the slider hitch but they forgot to put it back. So this particular floor plan, the 8290BS, is actually a rear kitchen model, and it also has an outside kitchen, which is kind of cool, so you have lots of kitchen space to work with. Power awning, before we go back there, I'll just point out that this has the metal wrap, so you'll notice that the fabric gets wrapped into that metal. The benefit to you on that is after a few years, that fabric doesn't get all weathered and little pinholes in it and becomes useless basically, and then $400 or $500 later you're replacing that every couple years. This is going to protect that fabric for a lot longer. Okay, coming back here, now this gets a little tight right over here, but I think we can show you what this does. Yeah, I'm a little too close to this camper, but this pulls out. This is a two burner stove. This also comes with an outside grill that fits right here. You can also bring a small TV out here if you want to, and you have your hookups for both 110 and the TV antenna hookup right there. This is a fridge. Now this is a 110 fridge, so this will only work off of if you're plugged into a generator or campsite power. It doesn't run off the battery like the fridge on the inside. You also have some nice cabinetry. You have some light switches here to work with, and this has kind of got its own built-in awning, even though it has an awning as well. But this is a little bit more sturdy, so it's gonna hold up to even if you have some wind and stuff like that. This is gonna be able to protect you from the sun and rain. This water heater is a very fast recovery rate water heater. This is a 6 gallon tank with a 16.2 gallon refresh rate per hour. So you can push buttons on the inside to start it. You don't have to come out here and light a pilot light. It can run off both gas, electric, or both, giving you that super fast recovery rate. This is also slam latch doors, so you don't have to lock this with, you know, pushing your key in and kind of turning. Also, you'll notice this is metal latches. There's no plastic hinges that you have to worry about breaking off. And then if you look up here, you'll notice this is all aluminum construction. It's double welded. And if you look right above that, a lot of guys are hiding this wood right here. They'll wrap it in something because they don't want to show that it's OSB chipboard. You can usually feel underneath it and notice that it's kind of rough. Rockwood, of course, doesn't have to do that because they are using plywood decking, 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood decking, and that is a much better choice because if you accidentally leave a vent open, you have a leak somewhere, maybe your camper's in storage for 2-3 months, that floor is completely rotted by the time you actually see the leak, unfortunately, and you can imagine replacing floors or a subfloor in a camper in such tight spaces is very labor intensive. Moving on, this is also got arms on it that are adjustable. So if you want to turn and make the water come this way or that way, you can do that. And this has two awnings, which is pretty cool. So one awning on here, and then the other one's actually on the outside of the slide out. That is super nice because usually, sometimes what they'll do is they'll put the awning over the slide. And the problem with that is you just took up all this space of what could have been nice shade. By putting two awnings on here, you get to extend that out much further and be able to stay in the shade. A couple other things I want to show you. One, this seam is pushed off to the side, so instead of this being on the corner here where all your rain and hail and wind and everything is hitting that can be problematic, they push that seam away from the camper, which is really nice. They also have a solar plug on here, so if you decide to hook up a solar panel, you can do that. We sell those in our parts store. You hook it up right here. Sometimes you're in the shade, right? So if you have a roof mounted solar panel, sometimes those can be problematic because of that. This one, if you hooked up a portable one, you can put it out in the sun and you can catch the most rays possible. This has the LCI ground control. That means it's auto leveling system. It's super nice. You push a button and instead of having to get up on blocks and having to worry about left to right, side to side and figuring out where your highs and lows are, you push a button and that's all taken care of for you. It also has a memory function on it. So here's the auto level button right inside here. It's inside the coach instead of on the outside, so you don't worry about little kids pushing buttons that they shouldn't be pushing and making trouble. It'll remember what your hitch height was of your truck, and you can push a button and it'll go right back to that same spot. Over here you have an outside shower. This is openable with a 751 key. And so anybody who has a camper probably has a key like this. And then this has hot and cold water ran to it. The benefit of that, of course, is if you have sand on your feet, if you don't feel like taking a shower inside, you can even, I've added one of these to my camper and put it right here. And that way we could kind of rinse off before we go inside. Get the dogs, the cat, whatever, if you want to rinse the cat off, I'm sure the cat would appreciate that. You also have a black tank flush. That flushes out all the yucky parts of your sewer tank for you instead of you having to do that. So the other alternative to not having a black tank flush is taking a hose in the camper through the hallway into the bathroom, opening up the toilet, putting a wand on there, and then sending that wand through the toilet. I know that sounds like a lot of fun, and if you want to avoid that, you get a black tank flush. This also has an antifreeze inlet. So the nice thing about an antifreeze inlet is during the winter time, you do not want to leave water in your system because it can freeze, right? And you need to send antifreeze through the system so that you don't bust your lines and your water pump and all that. Usually you have to take apart your water pump, hook the hose up to your jug of antifreeze, and then suck it through. This way you just have to turn a valve, hook up your jug of antifreeze right out here, and it makes the job a lot easier by just turning on all your shower and your sink and everything like that, and you're fully ready. And they also add a nice little light out here so you can actually see what you're doing while you're on the side of the coach. And you may have wondered, who was that girl that was randomly in the shot just a second ago? That is Colleen. She has just recently joined our sales team, and so she is catching up to speed, and she will soon be doing videos with us too. So, yeah. We also have a fully enclosed underbelly. So this is a some people call it all season or Arctic package, or there's all kinds of weird names for it. I just like to say that the underbelly's enclosed and that this has 12 volt heat pads on the tanks themselves, and the dump valves are inside the underbelly. A lot of people will say, oh yeah, ours is four season, but if they don't tell you all those different parts, they might be calling just the fact that it has corrugated plastic on the underbelly a four season coach, and that's stretching it a little bit if you ask me. Okay, a couple things to point out. One, starting with the roof of this coach, not that you can see that, but this is a TPO Superflex membrane. What that means to you, there's two different ways to make a roof. One is called an EPDM roof. That is a type of roof that was built, kind of they came up with that idea in the 80s, 90s era. That is just a rubber roof with some white chalk over it, and it stretches over, and that's great. The new way to do it is called the TPO or Superflex roof. That is 30% lighter, it has less rubber in it, it is more resistant to abrasion, it doesn't chalk or send down those black streaks down the side of the coach, you don't have to put UV protectant on it because it's not rubber. It's a lot better roof if you're looking into different types of roofs. Also, this has a spot for a backup camera, so if you decide to do that, we also sell those in our parts store. The best camera, if you're looking, is called the Furion observation camera. The cool thing about that one is you can see what you're doing or who's behind you as you're traveling down the highway, as well as backing up into your campsite. It's also the one that has a 100-foot range. We found that the ones that only have a 60-foot range don't quite cut it, and they'll start to be staticky and cut out your picture right when you need it the most. You'll notice this has a ladder, but it also has a hinge on the ladder so that you can put this down. This is a giant deal that folds down to the side, so a rack. You can see that it has slots, so if you decide to do bicycles, you can do that. It has a little pole that sticks right into here so that you have something to hold on to. You can put, of course, your portable generator, your extra water, your firewood, you name it, whatever. Extra kids back here, you can do that too. This has a 50 amp connection. It also has a little LED light on here. The reason why the 50 amp connection is important is because that allows you to put up to two ACs on here. If this is a 30 amp connection, you can only do one AC max. You also have your cable and satellite out here too. As we're going inside, I wanted to show you there is a light out here to, right by your stairs, and these are called a solid step or a sturdy step. They're coming out with different names because this is something that just recently came out this year, or last year, I guess you would say. This is also the Moride one, so it basically helps you put it up so you're not having to be He-Man in order to get those up and out of the way. But they're a lot less spongy compared to the rest. Come on in, I'll show you some of the other features inside. This is probably the most impressive living room for a rear kitchen because it has opposing slide outs. So as you can see, this just feels super open. And that's, again, you have a 3-foot slide out on this side, 3-foot slide out on this side, and that gives you all that extra room to work with. Starting over here, we have an IRB Technologies 4.0 Bluetooth. That means you're gonna have that very crisp sound. As far as Bluetooth goes, this does come with a TV. We just took it out so it didn't grow legs. But the cool thing about this is it has a hinge on the back, and you can actually hide stuff back there if you wanted to put, like, you know, say maybe there's your diaper bag or you know, stuff that you don't want laying around in the living room, you can just shove it back there and then it's easy access. You also have a fireplace in here that will heat up this entire room. So if you're at a place that has RV hookups, you might as well use their electricity, right? Because it's free usually. And that will allow you to not have to use your propane system. And you can turn on just it, just for the ambiance sake as well if you want to. Over here, you have a table and chairs. These do lift up. So if you want to be able to put some cards, a board game, sewing kit, whatever, you have that as well. This folds up, so if you want some elbow room for four adults, you have it. These windows, I forgot to show you on the outside, but these are the frameless windows. What that does is, and these are rain windows, so they open from the bottom only. That way, if it's raining outside, you can still, or let's say you went off and did your hike, forgot to shut the windows, no big deal. You're not gonna soak the entire coach because you left a window open. Yeah, and then you have an emergency window there, and there's also a, this is really cool too. The Signature Series has a daytime shade and then a nighttime shade. So if you're just wanting to try to block some sun or wanting a pitch black in here, you can do that. This also has the Wi-Fi Ranger built into it. This is the one of the highest technological coaches out there to make everything super easy. The Wi-Fi Ranger booster does one thing, and that's you have a little tiny Wi-Fi Ranger in your phone to be able to pick up Wi-Fi signal. This is a much larger antenna, so you can pick up more signals and a much stronger, faster signal, which, you know, we all use technology nowadays to be able to look up what the park looks like, get information for the park ranger or whatever, right? Seeing what the Broncos did over the weekend, all that can be done with that Wi-Fi range booster. So if there's a Starbucks down the street or something like that, you can connect to that and be able to get that signal that you're looking for. Also, in addition to that, for technology, this has a panel that will allow you to control everything from your phone. So as long as you have a smartphone, iOS or Android, you can put your slide out. So if you have that tree that's right next to you and you're not sure if you quite parked right, or the neighbor's right next to you, or whatever, or you needed to just check your tank levels, you needed to turn on your water heater and you don't want to go inside because you have muddy feet right now, you drag out your phone. You can listen to your music, you can put your slide outs out, you can put your awning in because it's getting too breezy, you can turn on your awning lights because you can't see what you're doing. Again, all from not having to walk inside and get all the floor muddy. So, like I mentioned, this has an awesome kitchen. This is a gas electric fridge. So this is a separate freezer fridge. This is an 8 cubic foot refrigerator with a nice raised panel cabinetry that makes it so it matches the rest of the cabinetry in here. This allows you to be able to keep your food cold no matter if you're plugged in or not. So some of the fridges that they're going to are just electric only. Those are kind of a pain because those fridges are great when you're parked, but a lot of times campers are moving, right? We have wheels underneath this. You need to be able to go places and you're not always sure that they have power where you're going. This can run off of propane and keep all your food cold. Counter space and cupboard space galore all over the place, as you see. Pull down sink faucet. This is the true Corian, DuPont Corian solid surface countertops. If it doesn't have this gold coin here for a sticker, it's not true Corian solid surface countertops. This is one of the few manufacturers that has stuck with the high grade. Some of the other guys are going to the cheaper stuff. And yeah, and the way that you can tell that is if they have that gold coin right there. All stainless steel sinks inside here. These are super sturdy as well. This is steel instead, or aluminum instead of plastic. So again, just nicer features is what you're gonna find in a Rockwood fifth wheel. Couple other things to show you. All the drawers in here, they have that soft close feature. That is super nice because you can imagine if you have this slide pushed in, this drawer opens up as you're going down the road and then you try to put your slide out, this drawer could easily take off this slide fascia, right? That would normally be a huge problem. That's a problem in a lot of coaches, to be honest with you, because you might have a cabinet door that popped open, whatever. This, as long as it's that last inch, it will auto close for you. It's just a nice feeling when you're closing the door or drawer, and it's also a nice safety feature so you don't ruin your stuff after you're parked. Over here, you have a knife rack in the back there. This also folds up to make a nice little backsplash. And again, they're doing nicer things in a Rockwood. That's kind of their signature thing, is everything's super nice and well done. So this, instead of being a piece of paper, that's a piece of wallpaper that's glued on, this is like more of like a thick rock type finish to it. 22-inch oven instead of a 17-inch oven. Instead of the rack height being here, it's down here, so you get about twice as much. You also have nice bread drawers down here. You have one under the fridge. You have more drawers over here. And these all pull out. And these even have the nice soft close on them. Hidden hinges throughout, you'll notice. There's no hinges that you see. That just makes that nicer look to it all. And then if you were able to feel back here, behind here, these are all screwed in. They're pocket screwed in. They use a jig to do that. They are not stapled in with just a piece of particle board. So that's nice as well. As you can see, these are not a head knocker. Some fifth wheels, they're about yay high, which is great if you want to knock your head every other time after you forget to duck. These guys, I'm 5'11", and I still have a couple inches underneath me. And then this is the theater seating. So this is cool. This pulls out. This is a great spot to store these. These are little end tables if you want to be able to put your drink here. These are heat massage light holders, and so that's pretty cool for your drinks. And then these just fit right here if you have like your iPad or whatever. You also have in here a 110 outlet and two USB outlets. Now this does have to plug into 110 power, this entire system. So unless you're plugged into campsite power, that stuff won't work. You also have a parachute pull cord, and this comes out too on both sides. And it's the perfect viewing spot for the TV if you guys are watching a movie. And then also a great spot for conversation, because you have the couch right across the way. And then if you were wondering, this does turn into a bed. I'll show you how that works. So the way this works is has two little bars. It's super easy. You don't have that weird metal bar in your back anymore like you have had in the past. You could sleep two adults on here no problem if you wanted to. Also, if you look above this couch, you'll notice there's nice little lights right here. So these are just push button, and you can turn them to be able to get the light right on your book that you're reading or whatever. Nice backlighting back here. Also, you have the ceiling fan and the light built into it, not just the ceiling fan. You have your air conditioning, and this is double ducted air conditioning. So instead of just a single duct, it's gonna cool down the unit a lot more evenly because of the double ducting. And then you'll notice this has about twice as many lights as most coaches as well. They do the nice crown molding all the way through. Again, this is real wood instead of the fake wood. Rockwood, like I said, they are just doing everything upgraded and nicer. Over here, this is the brains of the operation. So as you can see, you have the control for your awning. So if you want to retract your awning, you just push a button, and that awning, so if you look behind you, you'll see the awning that we put out is coming in. And again, you can just do that with your cell phone too if you wanted to, whatever you're feeling like. These are able to turn on and off all the lights in the coach very easily. This is the Wi-Fi range booster. Just so you know, I did do a video on how to use this, but if you didn't want to watch the video, you can just scan this little QR code and it will explain it all to you. It's pretty simple. You can have it up and running in a couple minutes. Digital for your furnace and your AC, so that's all built in one controller, and it's a dual zone, so you can set one to one temperature, the other to another temperature, and it can do it all for you. This is just an access panel, so there's no door, but if you needed to get in there for some reason, for plumbing or wiring reasons, that's why that's there. You also have a nice stair light right there. So not only do you have one on the entry of the coach, but you also have one so that if you're up in the middle of the night, you're not using a lot of lights and battery, but you can still see what you're going for. As you come in here, you'll notice I have tons of room. This is one of the largest showers that you see. It does have the seating area right here. So if you wanted to shave your legs, I haven't shaved my legs in a while, as you can see. You also have a skylight up here, so you have some natural light working. And soap holder, toothbrush holder, medicine cabinet, more LED lights throughout. And then on the backside, if Octavia, if you step into the shower over here, I'll show everyone that you do have access here for more storage. And then that max air vent fan. So this has a vent cover over the vent fan lid. That way it can move over 900 cubic feet of air per minute. So in other words, you can crank open that fan, open a window, and it's nice because this even has like a little gap on the top of the door here, so that you can even have this door closed and it's still pulling air through that camper. Porcelain commode down below instead of a plastic one. It's not going to smell as bad. It's going to be more sturdy. Light switches right here to be able to control everything. GFI outlet, more storage, and even a little plastic holder right there as well. Moving on into the bedroom. Charging center. So as you can see, you can charge up your cell phone or whatever else that's sitting on your table right here. These are all the push nice. So again, Rockwood, they don't cheapen up so some guys, what they'll do is they'll put maybe a couple nice cabinet trees in the kitchen, and then when you're not looking, they go to the cheap stuff. Rockwood did not do that. They even have all the nice hidden stuff. So if you look underneath here, notice that it's all plywood. Notice that this is all aluminum. Look under all the beds that you're looking at other coaches. This will all be wood, and half of them will already be bowed out because the strut isn't able to handle the pressure. And then not only do you get that outside grill, but you also get this table that goes on the outside, by the way. So yeah, and they're just, the mattress is not an entry level mattress. They put the nice handle here so you can easily put this up and down. So yeah, there's your mattress right there. Again, another emergency exit. If you need to get out of here in a hurry, you can do that. These side windows, a lot of times those are not openable. In Rockwood it is, so you can create a nice cross breeze. And then this is that second AC that I was talking to you about. And as you can see, even over on here, I have lots of headroom to work with. I'm not like having to have a weird step that's right here in the middle. They've put that way over here, and even this is a very shallow step to be able to work with. This is a queen bed. This is a 60 by 80 queen bed, and you still even have a little bit of room on each side. These open up. You can remove this here if you want hanging storage. Otherwise, you have drawers and stuff like that to work with. You do have a 110 outlet over here. I don't know if you have one. Oh, sure enough, you have one on that side too. And then this is, again, well laid out. Outlets even inside the front compartment right there. Spots for your shoes. It just seems like every way you turn, Rockwood does a very good job of putting it all together. Hey, thanks for joining me on checking out the Rockwood Ultralight Signature Series. This is the 8290BS. You should also check out the 8299 and the 8289WS. Those are also very nice fifth wheel options that are kind of like a couple's coach, kind of like this, where you could maybe fit a grandkid or two, but it's really made for the couple themselves, and does a really good job of laying out the floor plan. If you like this video, please hit the like button. That really helps me out. Also, feel free to comment if you have any questions or anything like that. You can reach me also via phone. Our phone number here is 970-313-4337. And to check out all of our pictures, all of our videos, all of the specs on all of these, you can go to thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.